Welcome to AS Educational Channel. Today, we'll see the method of finding unknown polarity of coils from the motor. Now, let us say we are having these 6 wires which have came out from the motor. Of course, the motor is star delta connected, and we don't know in which terminus there is a coil. So for this purpose, to find out the terminals in which there is a coil, we will use this series lamp. And for the next purpose of identification of polarity, we will use this power supply. Now this is a very simple method. Now first you have to make this switch on for this socket. Now these are the two probes of the series test lamp. We will connect this probe to say this wire, and we will move this probe to this. If there is a continuity, or if the lamp glows, then there is a, then this is a coil. If it doesn't glow, then there is no coil. So then we'll move this movable probe, that is this will be fixed, and this will move to second, third, fourth, and fifth. We'll see where the lamp glows. Where the lamp glows, that terminal indicates the coil between the fixed terminal and the movable terminal. Let us say that the coil has been found in this terminal. So there is a coil in between this terminal. Now similarly, same thing we can do for all the terminals. Again, the 4 terminals are left. Again, I will keep this as a fixed one, and I have found out the coil in this, so I am not going to touch these wires. Now I will move this here. Now say here the lamp glows, therefore here is a coil and left is the other. So this is very simple method to find out the coil which is available in the terminal, across the terminals of the motor. Now here the work of series lamp overs. Now we will use a simple lamp for the purpose of testing and a power supply. Now say we have found out these are the coils, but we don't know whether this is starting, this is finishing, or this is starting or this is finishing. And how to find out this, we will see it by a very simple method. Now let us connect this terminal to this one and this terminal to this one. Now I will connect the supply to this terminal and of course this terminal, right? Then there will be a transformer action. I'll make this power supply on, and then there will be a transformer action. Now if the coils are connected in parallel, then that means starting end is connected to starting end and finishing end is connected to finishing end. That means starting end of this coil is connected to starting end of this coil and finishing end is connected to finishing end coil. Then we will see that when we connect this lamp here, it will glow. If the lamp glows, then we can say there is a connection in such a way that starting ends are connected together. If the starting ends are not connected, then what will happen? There will be a series opposition between this coil, and there will be no EMF. This EMF induced by this and EMF induced by this coil, they will cancel each other, and there will be no EMF induced in this one, and therefore we will see that there is no glowing of the lamp. So as we have found out this for these two terminals, now I can clearly say that if the lamp glows, I will say that particular connection, this is S1, and when I have connected this and this, at that condition the lamp glows bright. Therefore this is starting ends are connected together, that means this is starting one, this is starting two. Similarly this is finishing end and this is finishing end of the second terminal. Now same procedure I will repeat for the remaining two. Now this is fixed, this is fixed. I will say this I will take this two and I will connect the lamp across this. Now I will connect this to this say terminal and I will connect this to this. Now if I connect the power supply to these two terminals and again if I connect the lamp to this one, now say this is the condition at which the lamp has not glown. That means with respect to this I have connected the series opposition. That means S1 is connected to F2 and F1 is connected to S1, and that means that is why this is, we can now mark the, if the lamp doesn't glow then we can say this connection is in a reverse manner, that is a series opposition. That means this is my finishing end of the third one and this is the starting end of the third one. So in this way we can find out the polarity amongst all these terminals. So once I know this is the, that means this is A1, this is A2, this is B1, this is B2, this is C1, this is C2. So accordingly now we can do the connections in star delta manner. Thank you very much for watching the video.